Hi Pisces, it's Elle here to do your next 72-hour energy reading. Thank you for being here. Thank you for liking, sharing, commenting, and subscribing to the channel. It is much appreciated. All links are below if you need to get in contact with me. So let's go ahead and jump into this. Thank you, Lord God, for blessing the Piscean with a clear, concise message from you. All right, so let's see what's going on, Pisces. The Fool card. All right, so you could be dealing with somebody foolish. They just out here doing whatever they want to do. It ain't no strings attached. They don't care, no obligation. They are not about to, I forget the damn word. But they're not about to, they don't owe you any explanation. This is what they're saying. I ain't saying that they don't, but I'm saying that it's how they acting. Acting as if they're single. They could, this is how I knew it. The Seven of Swords right behind it. Masquerading around like they're single, like they, you know, maybe like they're faithful to you. But this person has ulterior motives. They're out for themselves. They run from here to go over there. They run back to you. They come back to... It's craziness. It's craziness at best. It's absolutely asinine. It's tiresome, too. Somebody's just absolutely deceptive. They don't have any good energy to give right now because they're out for self. This is the lone wolf. This is somebody who really wants to go it alone. Whether they have not told you that or they have told you, they'd be okay with, you know, being by themselves. They already act very independent in nature, in relationship, in marriage anyway. This could be somebody that you're married to, or this is someone who is married. You could be sneaking around with this person. They have a lot of free time. They may travel towards you. They come towards you. It's carefree, no strings attached. The Emperor here, he feels like he makes up his own rules. He's built up an empire for himself. Therefore, he's not about to answer to anything or anyone else, especially not on his level. He also could be, you know, this is the guy who pays the cost to be the boss, you know. He could be financing somebody's entire life. Therefore, he's definitely not about to allow for anyone to shift his energy or shift what he has going on. The Queen of Pentacles, this could be the wife, or this is the wife. Or the main partner here, she's at home, she's nurturing, she's caring, she's concerned about her well-being, luxury, different streams of income. She knows her worth, she knows what she brings to the table. There is fertility and growth with her. This could be the other person, on the outside, the other woman, other man looking in on the outside, from the outside, wondering what's really going on, trying to gather knowledge or get some insight into spying, just outright spying, looking into, maybe even trying to stir up mischief or petty arguments here, gossip or slander. The Ace of Pentacles, yeah. This person could even, this could just be that somebody met this person and it was just supposed to be physical because it got physical really quickly. But now it's like growing into something else or morphing into something else here. Also, somebody could be trying to look in on somebody and see if the other person is pregnant or if there's an engagement ring or some seed of productivity or growth has been planted. Like, did they do something monumental or foundational together? The Ten of Wands, this person is really trying to, they understand that in this relationship, something needs to be looked at, it needs to be examined. They need to go deeper because they're not getting the truth. Also, this could just be a karmic situation, a karmic relationship to where two parties had to learn something here. Most times, relationships can turn karmic when you don't have any intentions for the other person or for the relationship. When you're just acting, when you're just doing. We get together, we have fun, we do this, we depart. We get together, we have fun, we do this, we depart. We get together, and then one day somebody wakes up and says, what are we doing? What are we? Aren't we boyfriend and girlfriend? And There's your karmic lesson, because if that was the end game, then that should have been what you started with. Don't engage with other human beings without declaration of intention. Declare what you intend to happen, or it will turn karmic most times. And this is the karmic situation that we make, you know, for ourselves, okay? Just because we aren't clear in our intentions. The Four of Cups, somebody regrets. They're in great remorse. They didn't see something right before them. They were too self-centered, too focused on themselves, too self-interest. You know, getting what I want right here, right now, and not seeing the beauty, the blessing, the gift that maybe another person or relationship was or is. The Five of Swords now. So somebody is in regret, that deep regret, to the point where they feel defeated. Okay, there's an air of defeat here. They just don't feel like it can come back or they can get it back. Their mind was playing tricks on them is what I just heard. Somebody just didn't see what was right before them. But the Five of Swords, they let something else or someone else interfere, run interference to where somebody was, you know, doing something else. It was like, look over here, don't look over there. I don't know what the fuck is going on here, Pisces. The Five of Swords also, it talks about question your motives or question somebody's motives, okay? Or someone could be questioning your motives in terms of what it is you really want from them. The Four of Pentacles, somebody could think that you're after the money, that you're greedy, that you're stingy, that you're a hoard of money, of resources. Somebody can feel like you're trying to hold on to them, or you feel like someone's trying to hold on to you, Pisces, because of money, because of your status, because of your wealth, this newfound wealth that you have. You've got people vying for your attention. You have to question everyone's motives here. King of Pentacles, yeah, Pisces, that could be you. If you're a male, it could be anybody, you know, but yeah, somebody's like, look, I have the bag, I am the bag, and I just can't trust anybody. I don't trust anybody right now. I feel like everybody's after me for my money. I feel like everybody wants something from me. But always keep in mind, people who are strong in their self-worth can never be used. So always go into every connection knowing that if you know what you have to bring to any table, know that somebody's going to want something from you. Therefore, you're not surprised, blindsided, or hurt by people asking of you. You know your worth. If I know, I'm going to be very base with this example, but if I know I'm worth $100 million and I'm going to the family reunion, I'm probably going to be asked of something, or something's going to be asked of me, maybe to finance the banquet hall, or to pay for everybody's t-shirts, or pay for us to the catering, or the buffet, or whatever. Something's going to be asked of me. I have $100 million. I know my worth. I'm not going to be surprised. I'm not going to be upset. I understand that people are going to want something of me. Now, I get to place the stipulations and ramifications on that. I'm not giving out all my money. I'm not doing outrageous things. But at the same time, people who are strong in their self-worth can't be used. And that also goes for the intangible. If you know you're super smart, and every time you come around, somebody's asking you about this and asking you about that, don't get mad. Don't get upset that they're always trying to use your intellectual property. They want to use your mind. Just put stipulation and boundaries on that. You know, I'm not going to just give you the answer. I'm not going to always answer the questions. Or you can be funny. Like, hey, you only got two questions today. That's it. So make them good, you know. So anyway, that's what that saying is about. So I don't know, for some of you, if you feel like somebody is using you, if somebody feels like you're using them, that's how somebody feels, okay? The Six of Pentacles. Also, there's an energy of somebody giving to two parties, two or more parties, okay? Somebody is dividing your time, their energy, their resources, their motivation. Somebody's determined here to do what the fuck they want to do. The Tower. It's almost as if someone wants to get caught. Eight of Cups, Pisces, you might be walking away because you found something out. Something came to light that maybe somebody was having an affair, spending time with someone else, okay? And maybe they're choosing them over you. You're going to choose yourself over this third party. Okay, Pisces, this is your reading. I hope it resonates. If it does, go over to the website, book there. Take advantage of the text question also. Thank you, Pisces. Many blessings to you. Bye.